Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Today we'll be airing the 30th SEA Games, the Philippines 2019 squash event. So we have Singapore's Au Yong Wayan against Philippines' Yvonne Aisa Dalida. So today your commentators will be me, Chua Man Tong, and Timothy Leong. Let's hear a few words from the man himself.
Hi.
Tim, what do you think about today's match?
I think it'll be a tough one. Both players have played each other recently in the Singapore squash circuits, and even though the scores were quite tight, and I think we have an exciting match lined up for us today.
So a bit of a background of the two players. So Wayan has been starting part-time and playing professionally for about maybe 2 to 3 years. And Aisha, I think, has been a full-time squash player while managing maybe a part-time job in the squash academy. I'm not too sure about that. So squash-wise, I think perhaps, although Wayan may be a bit younger, but she has a lot more international experience. But Aisha is a real fighter, isn't she?
Yeah, definitely. And you'll probably be able to hear her on court later as well.
Yeah, now it's a 2 minute knock up, and we'll come back again shortly.
Alright, and we are back as we get this game underway. So Singapore here serving Au Yong Wayan, ranked 117 in the world, against Yvonne Aisa Dalida. And here Au Yong draws first blood, keeping the pace high and keeping Yvonne back at the backcourt. And yep, another point. Fast and furious.
Yeah, man, Wayan's starting really well. And perhaps Yvonne's feeling a bit of the nerves from the big crowd outside the courts cheering her on. As you can see, Wayan is stepping up the pace, keeping Aisha deep in the back and then pushing her all around the court.
Oh, that's a lovely touch from Yvonne. You know, Au Yong using all six corners of the court really well, but opened up a loose shot at the last moment, and Yvonne capitalized with a Fantastic straight drop. Here we see some interference. And oh, a let. Interesting.
The players are trading. Backhand drive, some of the backhand wall. And now cross court from YN. A wide cross court in the deep corner. Had Alisa down to a knees. Nah, I'm joking. So Tim, what are your score predictions for this match?
I think it'll be close. I'm gonna give Aoyoung a 3-1 advantage. What do you think?
I think it may be a thriller for YN. Aisha seems to be struggling with her movement. And I think Aisha is also like organizing the SEA Games transport and booking of courts and stuff, and it must be really tiring for her to organize and also play this event. Being a student athlete yourself, how do you think she manages that?
I think it's a great job from her, and yeah, really applaud her efforts and just Yeah, so I think it's a great effort for her to just try and keep playing as well as organizing this event. And I myself, I play and I coach part-time, and I know what kind of stress and what kind of pressure she's under. So really kudos to her. And right now she's putting up a pretty good fight, even though the scores say otherwise, but no, we'll just see how this match goes. Right now, Aoyoung 7-1 up in the first game.
Yeah, Aoyoung's starting pretty well. Got lucky, joined Nick at the front there, and she's 8-1 up. Things are looking good for Singapore. Another Nick at the back. Wow. Aoyoung's getting her length really deep. How important is the length in this game?
Well, it's super important. You know, the length is the most basic shot that you can play in squash. And right now, Aoyoung is using it. You know, just pinning and pressuring Aisha at the back. And just alone with the length, she has managed to claim the first game 11-1. Astounding first game from Aoyoung.
Things aren't really looking very good for the Philippines side, but I'm sure their coach will change some strategy for Yvonne and ask her to implement something different against the more experienced and more versatile Aoyoung. So let's see what's in store for us in the second set. Yeah, one love. Both players are back on court and we are ready for the second set. Will we see a change in strategy from the Philippines side? And how will Aoyoung manage to continue her winning streak from the first set to the next? Just as we started, Yvonne starts with more of a spring in the step, and there's a bit of a blockage in the middle. There seems to be a bit of ambiguity in how the referees do their make their decisions, especially this morning where there was quite a coincidence between the Singapore player against the Indonesian player, where the Indonesian player was given the match because the Singaporean player, Sneha, hit the Indonesian player on her nose, on her mouth, and then her nose twice, which caused her to bleed and eventually went to the hospital. What do you think about that, Tim?
I think it's unfortunate. You know, squash is considered a contact sport. You know, you're in an enclosed area and you have to make your effort to move out after you hit the ball. And I guess it was a bit of an ambiguous decision this morning, but you know, matches still go on and there are still many events, and we'll just see what the referees call.
Yeah, I guess this may be why squash isn't chosen as an Olympic sport, as there are so many ambiguities, especially in terms of refereeing. And if this doesn't improve, things may go downhill and we won't even get to the Olympics anytime soon. So, as you see here, Daida is drawing close to Aoyong, 2-2.
There seems to be quite a bit of interference at the tee area. No, Aisha feeling that Aoyong is not clearing fast enough. And right now you see that the referee has given Aoyong the point. No. Now this is one of the problems that the players kind of face. No, players and referees are often not on the same page. So how do you overcome that, Matong?
I think certainly there are some rules, and the way players interpret and the way referees interpret from an outside point of view may be very vastly different. So in the end, it's a very subjective matter, and it boils down to how good or how well the referee is dealing with such situations. So Daida is 5-3 now in the lead, making a mistake, and Aoyong is back 4-5.
Yeah, from this aerial view, you can see just how well Aoyong uses the corners. No, she had a bit of a jittery start, making a few unforced errors, and Aisha capitalized with some really good shots. And now Aoyong's drawn level, still making use of all corners, especially the back corners, pressurizing Yvonne back to the corners. A lovely burst, and oh, what a split from Aisha. No, unfortunate not to get that, but a really great effort. She seems to have sustained a mild injury.
Daida looks ready. Good line from Wayan again. Getting a corners. And then loose shot in the middle, and Daida managed to finish it with a straight drop.
You can see squash is a brutal game, man. You can be pressurizing your opponent, but one loose shot can just cause you to lose the entire point, as you can see right there. And that's a beautiful ball from Aoyong. Good two wall balls that didn't touch the sidewall. Really made Aisha stretch, and she really just didn't get that. 7-6 to Aoyong. This game is a pretty tight game, isn't it?
Yes, it's really tight. And you see a change in strategy in Yvonne. She's playing a little bit more attacking, getting up higher on the tee, trying to force errors from Aoyong. And I think it's working well, just that she has to be a bit more steady. And let's see how it goes. Both of them making really unnecessary, unforced errors. And I think that's what just sets both of them apart. So the more consistent player will probably get more winning points from the other.
That's right, Mantong. You can see Aisha's strategy is really paying off. You know, the high lobs and the change in pace really rattling Aoyong. And she's making quite a few unforced errors. So can she claw back and can she get the upper hand to win this game? And great length from Aisha. Dying length at the back. Nothing much Aoyong could have done about that. She leads 9-8 in this second game. Can she draw level?
And lucky miss. The courts here are a little different from the traditional courts. It's a little bouncy. And the front warnings are not as big. But the back warnings are a little bigger. Surprisingly. And Daila just made a mistake. And another unforced error. And Aoyong leads 10-9 game ball. Another mistake from YN and they draw 10 all.
A little bit scrappy, they're just trading errors here and there. And now we are at 10 all, player to win by 2 points. That's a great boys from Aisha. Great boss. No, really caught Aoyong off guard. And she leads 11-10 game ball in this second game. That was a loose ball from Aisha and Aoyong just capitalized and played a nice straight drop, leveling it at 11-all. You can really see how important the length is, can't you, Mantong? The first one to pin the opponent behind and force an error normally wins.
Yeah, I think this is especially so for the women's game where I mean, physiologically, women are not as fast. So if you are, if you manage to move them around from the front to the back and you get your deep corners really well, they will struggle to pick the balls from the back. Especially when they are moving. So it's trouble now, nothing between them. Let's see who manages their nerves a bit better and play more error-free squash to win the set. That's when I was talking about errors. I think they each made like around 6 to 7 errors, did they?
There are plenty of errors this game. It's really gifting the opponent the points, you know. Squash is a brutal game and you really have to earn your points. So unforced errors are really just a waste. And great. Good shot, good drop shot from Aisha. You know, seemed that there was minimal interference and the referee allowed it to carry on.
Another volley boss, perfect volley boss by YN. And she's up 14-13, game ball. Will she convert? That's a really high drop. And YN wins the game. It's 2-love to Aoyong. Very close game. And it's exciting to see what's gonna happen in the third set. Sorry for the delay, there was some technical difficulties. Now it's 3-0 in the third set. Ayong hits a beautiful drop shot. And she leads 4-3. Nice backhand straight drive and a good cross court, and Aisha wasn't even close enough to get that. Oh, good cross court, Nick. It's 4-5.
You see YN really using the corners and stepping up the pace. Aisha really just trying to slow it down a bit. Oh, that's a beautiful ghost. She gets it and tight get. Oh, that's a lovely length from YN. Wan's length has been pretty solid all game, hasn't it, Mantong?
Yeah, and she's mixing it up well with the two wobbles, which is catching Aisha at least a couple of times this set. And, oh, a bit of a pushy in the middle. I think it's given a let. Another nice cross court deep in the corner, and Aisha couldn't get there on time.
Yep, and YN is just running away with this game. 8-4 up in the third. Aisha really needs to find a way to get the ball past YN, keep her off the tee if she wants a fighting chance in this match. And here, another unforced error from YN, hitting the boat into the tin. Really unnecessary error.
Aisha looks like she's struggling with her lower back. Not too sure why. Maybe from the slip previously. But encouraging signs from Singapore. And it looks like they'll be able to convert this match and into the semi-finals against the first seed. Aisha draws 1 point back in 6-10.
Aisha saves one match ball. Beautiful serve, forcing another error from YN to save two now. Three more match balls. Can she hold up against YN? Aisha really stepping out of pace, making YN scramble back and fourth on the court. And an unforced error from Aisha, gifting YN the match. 11-7 in the final game. YN wins 3 games to love. Congratulations to Singapore. They proceed to the next round, the semi-finals of the women's singles event. Great effort from both players. There was some fantastic squash we saw.
Yeah. So we conclude the girls quarterfinals, women's quarterfinals, and we'll be back shortly for the men's match. Next female match, sorry.
7-2. Yeah. 9-2. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, let's all welcome officiating referee and players in the Quarry 3 men's singles.
Thank you. Time.
Thank you.
Please. Guess what? 6-3.
15 seconds. 5-2.
Seven.
left. Two left.
Thank you. sakit ka marami. Ito ay 5-7 na.
Two, one, go. Thank you. Nice. Thank you. Come on, Samuel. Down. spread the crowd.
Come on, Samuel.
Come on, Sam.
Go, Bert, come on. All right, good stuff, good stuff. Come on.
Come on, Robert.
Come on, Robert.
Another man, Rainbow.
Come on, Bert!
again. Needs two games to love.
Robert!
3-1.
Come on, Samuel. Get it back.
luck.
Come on, Daniels.
Thank you. this thing out, come on.
Focus.